According to a June 22nd communication addressed to members of parliament by Henry Waswa Yoweri, the deputy clerk to parliament, the August House is set to close for 2 weeks starting Monday, 28th of June, in order to disinfect the parliamentary building. But this has sent MPs into panic and many have opposed the decision.
On opinion, no, because we are at war and we are soldiers. We represent our people here. At this moment, when we are still setting up leadership at parliament, as we talk now, we don't have a parliamentary commission. As we talk, we don't have fully constituted committees of parliament. And this is a time when Ugandans would want to speak to government.
The big role to play, particularly during this very terrible time, in that they do the oversight role, and two, because we need supplementary budgets, I am quite sure that this pandemic was not well organized, well thought after, and it may require Parliament to sit and maybe pass some of these policies that are very, very vital at this time.
Lawmakers are concerned that the fortnight suspension of Parliament will sabotage business in the House, since many committees which are meant to check government have not been established yet, including the Parliamentary Commission.
We are in bad times. We have not made any committees. We don't know which committees we belong. At the same time, Parliament is a very important institution when it comes to oversight and appropriation. A plan from the Prime Minister's office has just come out. This plan has not been presented to Parliament. We don't know anything about it.
The main motive of closing Parliament for 2 weeks is to make sure that money goes uncensored. Actually, there is going to be a lot of embezzlement of government funds, because no one is going to take the responsibility of checking government, because the main duty, the main role of Parliament is to check the executive. So I think they are going to take advantage of the 2 weeks when Parliament is down.
MPs have asked Parliament's administration to instead consider conducting sittings via video conference, since Parliament rules of procedure were amended recently to provide for electronic sittings.
This 20th century, we believe our parliament should not be closed because there are virtual means at which people can discuss and raise issues. This is a very critical moment whereby our people need to hear from us, whereby we need to ask for accountability, whereby we need to task government to act as fast as possible in whatever means of giving relief to our people. So it is too sad that we have to now look for alternatives at which we have to write to the Prime Minister and then reach out to her to say that we task different ministries to deliver to our people.
Unfortunately, we are in a country where there's no respect for Parliament. We have duties. Our people elected us to effect those duties. And we are here at Parliament because we have a responsibility to fulfill. Right now, I'm just coming from my pigeon box, collecting bills. You can see. I don't know when we are going to debate about these bills, when they are coming up with the arrangements to close Parliament.
Others are suggesting that sittings be moved to Kololo.
It is the best alternative, because we've been sitting. In case you tell us that we are going to sit for 2 weeks, just know Ugandans are going to die. I want to come on the floor of Parliament. Then I raise my issue from Masurita. I raise my issue from Kachiri. Because I right now people are dying. Let us go to Kororo. Let us leave Parliament. Let them fumigate, do each and everything, but we'll be sitting there.
Shifting the venue is very possible. I've been there always in Kororo. We can go anywhere. The parliament doesn't mean we sit in the parliamentary building. Anywhere can be a parliament, as long as the speaker is there and all tools that make a parliament are there. So, you see, these people have a different mission more than us. If Uganda has ever needed a parliament, it needs it more now than any other day.
However, MPs Brandon Chintu of Kagoma North and Medad Segona of Busiro East are in support of closing the August House. They also want MPs to be tested for COVID-19 before returning for duty.
Well, we can only make intervention when we are alive. If it is intended to protect life, I think we can not propose otherwise. That's number one.
We have been attacked. This is not a joking issue, it's a health crisis. Of course, in the normal sense, you would see that it's not really, it's inconveniencing the work of Parliament, but we're also looking at the lives of many Ugandans. Like, we're aware that a couple of MPs have tested positive, and this is something that we all ought not take for granted.
Today, the Director of Communications and Public Affairs of Parliament, Chris Obore, has released a press statement refuting reports that over 200 MPs tested positive for COVID. He noted that the shutdown of Parliament is a precautionary measure for safety of MPs. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.